Getting started with Syndex indexing software. Syndex offers the professional indexer unmatched features that make creation of the index easier and more efficient. But the best part about Syndex is its ease of use. In this tutorial, we will cover the basics of how to build an index using Syndex for Windows and where to learn more about Syndex capabilities. To start a new index in Syndex, go to the File menu and choose New. Enter a name for the new index and click Save. Note that index files are saved with the file extension .cdx. Don't worry about making formatting, style, or sorting decisions at this point. Syndex comes preset with the most commonly chosen settings to get you started, and it's simple to make changes later. Your index data will always remain intact. To get started adding entries, open a record window by choosing New Record from the Edit menu or using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-K. Make your entries in the fields provided in the record window. Place the main heading at Main, use the down arrow or tab key to move to the page field and enter the page number. To save the record, press the page down key and that's it. You've entered your first record and are on your way to creating your first index. Records with subheadings are entered slightly differently. After the main heading is entered, press the Enter key to create an empty field for the first subheading. The Tab key or down arrow moves to the page field, and pressing the page down key saves the record. To enter a record containing a cross-reference, enter the main heading as usual, move to the page field and enter the cross-reference, and press the page down key to save the record. Syndex will recognize the leading word C in the page field and correctly interpret this entry as a cross-reference. As you continue to add entries to the index, you'll see the index building in the background. To view the index in a sorted view, close the record window by pressing Ctrl-Enter. Syndex contains shortcuts that can speed up record entry by reducing the need to move your hands from the keyboard to the mouse and back again. With the record entry window open, active shortcuts appear in bold font under the Edit and Character menus. The online help file also shows record editing shortcuts which can speed up record entry. Shortcuts will be covered more fully in an upcoming video on efficient entry of records. There are several ways to navigate through the records in your index. To move to a particular entry in the index, whether it appears on the current screen or not, just type the first few letters of the main entry. The view will automatically jump to the appropriate spot in the index. The Go To function under the View menu offers another way to move to a particular entry in the index. Enter characters of the main heading and click on OK to move to the specified record in the index. You can also enter characters of main and subheadings separated by a semicolon and go to the entry. Preference settings in Syndex create the flexibility to tailor the program's operation to suit the task. For example, with the default program settings, the record entry window opens in a fixed mode, but the editing preferences can be changed to open a separate record window, which can be positioned and sized exactly as you wish or as your material demands. To edit an existing record, highlight that record and press Enter, or double-click on the record, and the record window will open for editing. You can save the edited record and close the record window by pressing Ctrl-Enter. Alternatively, if you close a record by clicking the X on the title bar, Syndex will query you as to what you want to do. Help for Syndex users is available in several formats. For extensive in-depth explanations of all the features Syndex provides, refer to the User's Guide. Or go to the program's Help menu and browse the thorough coverage of topics there. Quick reminders for icons on the toolbar are available by hovering the mouse over the toolbar. And help is also available for many dialog windows by clicking on the question mark on the title bar, then clicking on any item within the dialog window. The Indexing Research website includes a list of frequently asked questions on how to solve problems using Syndex. For any other questions about the full range of Syndex functions, please feel free to email us. Video tutorials on other Syndex topics are under construction and will soon be available at the Indexing Research website.